Good evening, everyone. My name's Heath Haskins, Code Primate, and of course I'm going to do another Lumber Tycoon video because we didn't reveal the secret lighthouse thingy, of course. So, yeah, I'm back in here. I've already dropped off 3 dynamite up there because dynamite tends to, like, reveal things, and we're going to go take a look. But first, I wanted to try and drive this thing one last time because I know I can do this. It feels really slick, but I bet I can do this. I bet. Oh gosh. Come on. Please. Nope. Straighten it out. All right, my wheels have gotten off turn here. Okay. Maybe if I come out and push from this side. Push. Come on. I gotta get the car up there. All right. Give us a little bit of leeway. Oh no. Opposite side. All right. One more time. All right, it's gonna take like master driving skills to do this, but wrong spot. Okay, let's go. By the way, if you guys don't know, I'm actually using the right mouse button to move my camera to where I need it, so I can see how the wheels are turning and stuff like that. Oh gosh. All right, here we go. Up. We're on. Oh, I got this. Come on, keep going. No. Oh, now we're, like, seriously stuck. Okay. Oh, how many of you were like, no, Code, so close? Comment down below. All right, this is, like, really exciting. I should not be having this much fun about falling down. Oh, no. Okay. Do not get stuck, Code. Do not get stuck. Come on, close and open one more time. By the way, this is not going to be a very long video. This is probably only going to be about 10-15 minutes long. So don't get too excited, but we will definitely explore and have fun in this episode. Whoa, there we go. Okay, here we go. Maybe if I just speed run it, just run it up there. What do you think? Just don't even slow down, Code. Just keep going. Momentum is key. Momentum is key. Key, code, no! Okay, that's it. Get out. Leave it. Leave the truck. It's okay, it was a rental. Oh, man. So we're gonna have to walk all the way up there, but that's okay. By the way, this is also one of the reasons I don't edit any of my videos. So for those of you that were like, oh my gosh, this is the worst video ever because you never edit. That's okay, you've probably just got here, and I will, you know, I will forgive you for not knowing, but that's one of the main things about my channel is to not edit. And I kind of feel like if I were to start editing my videos right now, it would be like selling out about what my content is all about. I don't know. It could be, it might not be, but for the most part, I like playing straight through because it allows me to just say whatever's in my head, and I don't have to worry about the pauses or the breaks or anything like that, because with my attention deficit hyper disorder, my ADHD, I can continue to, like, just shout out whatever's in my head. Oh, look at that. Sorry, that's my cell phone tower. I get great reception out here, by the way. Lumber TNT. It's my cell phone service. Oh, man. Okay. There's the drop. Oh, by the way, we are in the winter biome. Right down there are the rocks that you have to blow up. They're just on the opposite side of the mainland. And then you drive over here to this little back area, and there's a ramp that comes up here like this, comes over here like this, over to the land bridge, comes over here, and then it wraps around under here, and then over to here, and then it comes up here like that, to this little area where you have to do the little, like, walkway like I just did. Anyhow, that's that. Enjoy. oh gosh, I hope my TNT's still there. Whew. I was like, if I just wasted all that time and my TNT disappears, that's wasteful. All right, so on your walk up to the winter biome, and it's not hidden. Like, it's not like, see that right down there? It's not What's going on here? There's something on my mouse pad. It's not like he hit it. It's out in the open. So it's not really an Easter egg. I mean, it is an Easter egg because it's something that's like not part of the actual game. If I have time, I'll show you the game that he took it from, which is his game. But it's more of a model that he did. Oh gosh. Okay. First things first, let's just walk it. Oh gosh, it's so dark. Steven! Filters! Steven! Steven! He fell asleep again. That's okay. Okay, let's see if I can do this myself. That's the game capture. There we go. And filters. There we go. Now I can see. So, there's the cave where we came in at. There's the TNT. Walking this way, walking. And there's the lighthouse. Now let's go look every nook and cranny. I should probably turn on my shift lock so I can look through the walls and stuff. Anything up there? Anything up there to explore? Nothing. If I jump down, am I going to be able to jump back up? Yep, okay. That's fine. Filters on OBS is amazing, by the way. Anything back here? Anything? Nothing? Alright. So let's go take a look at the lighthouse itself. Oh. Wait, can I walk on that? I could. Oh. Can we press E on the door? No, we can't. Okay. So there's nothing about the lighthouse that seems to be special. Maybe if I... Oh, wait. Hold on. Jump. Oh, come on. Just get up there. Oh, no. Come on. Oh. I'm sure somebody with, like, better obby skills has already tried to jump up there. Oh, gosh. Alright, I'm on the door. There we go. Yay! Actually, that's a great screenshot. Nice. Alright, print screen that. Nice. So, now let's look on the inside. Doesn't look like there's anything. No hidden messages, no writings. Nothing of that sort. What is this? It's like a lookout tower thingy. Binoculars. And there's some barrels or something right there. Batteries maybe? So, no, it's fine, Steven. You can go back to sleep now. Yeah, I found the filters button. Steven. Okay. So, let's turn on shift lock and start looking through things. So, shift lock. And this is on PC, by the way. I don't know if there's a... Xbox version of this. Oh, you can kind of see on the inside, but I mean, there's not really too much to reveal. Okay, let's go look through the walls. Over here? Nothing behind there. What about back here? Maybe? Oh, what's that? Nope, that's just the top of one of the bricks. Let's go over here. Nope. Nothing. Okay, nothing. Nothing. Nothing back behind there either. Although that's the top of the other brick that we see here. All right, here we go, here we go. Let's look through here. Come on. Nothing in there. Nothing. That's a second brick right there. Nothing here. Nothing. Can't really see on that side. Okay. And this side. Good. And this one here. Oh, although that does look like a little door or something. It's not. It's just where the two pieces come together. What is that? That is the bottom side of the slide. Oh, cool. That's down into nothingness right there. Okay. Let's go get our TNT. And let's try it out on the lighthouse itself. Turn off shift lock. And here we go. Gotta get the TNT. Gonna blow up you and me. Gonna be glorious. We're at 11 minutes, by the way. If you guys haven't been keeping track. Because I do. Alright. Alright, here we go. TNT time. Blow it up. That would be awesome if you use TNT and all of a sudden the lighthouse lights up. Please. Please work. Okay, here we go. TNT. Test number one. Anything? Anything? Oh. Nothing. Okay, fine. All right, let's do the second one. Should we do it on one of the walls or? By the way, if you've got more ideas about where to place this stuff or what to do, would love to hear about it down in the comments section. All right, let's go ahead and open it up, and then I'm going to try and stick it on the door. There we go. Come on, blow open the door. Give me the golden axe that's on the inside, or the boat. Oh, what was that? I think I was just too close. Okay. Took down a lot of life, though. Oh my gosh. Oh my goodness. And last one. Last one. Because we're not going to be able to do anything else after this. Except maybe run around for a little bit. But then that's going to be boring for you guys because you're going to be like, oh god, it's taking so long. Tell you what, in this episode I will try and jump the truck down inside the what's it as well. Alright. I feel like we should go try this back wall. I don't know why. I mean, there's nothing behind the walls. We saw that. But I feel like we need... Okay, yep, we're going to drop it right here. Here we go. Make sure that we're far enough back. Ooh, we were not far enough back. We still took damage. Wow. Anything? Anything revealed? Nothing. Nothing. What? Alright. Well, I don't want to walk all the way back, so let's do this. Reset. Oh, are you awake now, Steven? Are you awake? Would you mind hitting the filters button for me? Yeah, no, the color correction, Steven. Yeah, that one. Thank you. Oh my gosh. Go back to sleep. Steven's getting lazy on me. Might have to get somebody else in here. There we go. All right, let's skedaddle. Because if I remember right, The rocks are back in place. Yep, the rocks are back in place. Okay, so we gotta go get some TNT. Let's go get some TNT, then we're gonna blow that thing up, and then we're gonna get to the other side, and then we're gonna jump the car into the chute. Which should be amazing. Even if I crash and land upside down, it's still gonna be awesome. Yes, I wanna spend $100. Absolutely. Saranac. Oh, a lot of you were asking what's wrong with the dialogue boxes and the things that are popping up in the negatives. Like, you see how it said thank you, but it was black with like gray text? That is a bug inside Roblox. A lot of the GUI stuff is on Roblox, not Lumber Tycoon 2 itself, per se. What is going on? Weird. That's strange. There's my cell phone tower. Up there in the air. That's how many things it took to get to Palm, right? And I was thinking about it. The Palm drivable bridge that I was talking about making, it's 6 of those. Now, one of those, like one line of those doors, took me almost 2 months to build from scratch. So I'm not sure I'm going to be building a drivable Palm bridge on slot number 2. Just saying. Oh, by the way, always make sure that you buy 2 TNT, because if you don't, and you blow up the rocks and you didn't get all of them, then you're not going to be able to get through. So, whenever the rocks were still glitched, you could just drive through them. Just saying. There we go. Okay, cool. And go. Woo! Here I go again on my own. What's going on with my face? Do I look orange? Hashtag orange code. Code orange. Wonder if it's my filters. Oh, and to the person that was asking if you could make a border for my thing. I use green screen, so I don't use borders. Thank you though. Appreciate it. I was thinking about like setting up a room with all my fan stuff and fan art and toys and stuff, like all my original Nintendo stuff and Coleco stuff, and like put them on shelves so it's like in the background, and then take a picture of it and then use that as my background, and then like whenever I get new things, I'll place them on the shelves, take a picture and update it and stuff like that. It was a thought. I'm not too sure how far I'm going to go with that. There's a lot of stuff I need to get done, especially this week. Oh, and for those of you that don't know, I don't do this for a living. This is, I don't do YouTube as a full-time job. I still go to work. I'm an application programming analyst. So I create business applications for a company that I work for. I don't do full-time YouTube. So for those of you that are like, oh my gosh, why are you never on? That are for the people that are messaging me and sending me messages like while I'm at work. Guys, I'm at work. I'm probably not going to respond. So please don't be mad. Okay? Hey, I got them all in one shot. Nice. Well, I got some more TNT just in case we need it. How long is this episode going? Oh my gosh, we're already 18 minutes in. I might get a double episode. So that first episode was a collaboration, and it was over 40 minutes long. Whoa. Which was much, much longer than I had planned on. But I mean, we got a lot of ice wood. So I don't even know what I'm going to do with it all. Make an entire Iceland base. Somebody said make an igloo. I'm like, oh, that's a good idea. Somebody else said, what happens if you put the ice in the refrigerator? Like, that's brilliant. And you should. You should chop it into, like, little bitty pieces, like, as small as you can get, and then, like, throw them in there, and it could be, like, ice for your cup or something. Oh, man. There's so many ideas to do with the new wood. You know what? I don't care that I've got TNT in the back of my car. I'm just gonna jump straight off and into the jump. Now, we have to think about how the physics work inside lumber, because the lumber physics use Roblox default physics. Hold on. Test, test. Okay, test. Testing, 1, 2, test. Test, glorious, glorious, test, glorious. Am I using the right microphone?
Test, test.
Yeah, that's the right one. Okay. I was worried there for a second. Oh, gosh. There we go. Get up, on, up and over, dude. Okay, so with the way Roblox physics work, as soon as I go off, the front of my truck is going to dip down. So we're going to do this motion. All right. Now, if I were to drive off backwards and do a slight turn at the very end, I should be able to twist my truck and change directions. Actually, you know what? You know what? Hold up. Ideas are happening. I'm gonna try something. Alright. Light and throw.
Whee!
Oh, I heard it go off way down there. Nice. So if there was ever a war in lumber, I know where I'm coming, but I gotta get stocked up with TNT first. Got my own cannon up here. Okay. So open the doors, open the tailgate, and then drive off straight backwards here. Zoop, doo-doo. That way you can do a little bit of driving. And I should be able to do the same thing right there. Hold up. Okay. Right here. Woo! Nice! Oh my gosh. This is gonna be so cool. Well, maybe. This might be like a horrible, horrible idea. But I'm gonna do it anyway. Okay. So I'm gonna drive straight at the wall and I'm gonna turn at the last second. So here we go, here we go. No! No! Wait, wait! I made it! I made it! Oh my goodness. There is no way I just did that. Turn on the lights and I'll glow. Please tell me I can go all the way up. Please tell me I can go all the way up. Please tell me I can go all the way up. No! There's not enough momentum. Oh gosh. Okay, I'm gonna go to the very top and then let go. Hopefully the momentum will take us. Take us, take us, take us, take us, please. Woo! Nice. All right. I want to do it again. Woo. That is too good. One more time. One more time. This is going to take a second to get up there, but it's totally worth it. Totally worth it. All right. Got to put out my stabilizers. All right. Straight off the edge. Straight off the edge. Please. Please. Yes. Glorious. Wait, wait, wait. Come back, car. Come back. By the way, I don't think the cabin changed at all. Oh, gosh. If you guys don't know about the cabin is from the winter event of 2016, maybe? And that's where the glow fir wood was out here. And it's now located in... Wait. Can you bring the glow fir wood up here? Uh-oh. If you chop a glowwood tree down in Tic-Tac-Tort's place and you bring it up to the cabin and drop it in, does it give you the same bonus as it used to? That is a question. A very good question. Because maybe the programming is still there. Because the only thing he removed was the trees. I know that if you drop in the normal wood, it will convert and turn into planks of whatever that wood was. So like pine would turn into sparkle pine, oak would turn into sparkle oak, elm would turn into sparkle elm. What I'm talking about is like it would have the little fiery things coming off of it. Now, you can't claim that wood at all, and it doesn't work if you try and get it into a what's it? like, there's no way to claim the wood itself. It just goes straight through conveyor belts and stuff like that. So, all right, I'm gonna try this without the stabilizers, but you're gonna see how much more the truck will bounce. Ooh. Oh my gosh! Oh, stop! Oh gosh! Oh man, I don't know what to do. Should I try going off backwards? No, code. Okay, right there's where we came through at, so. Alright. No. Here we go. There we go. Yes! Go! Woo! No! Awesome. It's not quite as high as I thought it was going to be, but still amazing. Thank you, everyone, for watching this episode of Lumber Tycoon 2 with me, Heath Haskins, Code Primate, as we discover secrets, discover lighthouses, discover Easter eggs, and all that cool stuff, and discuss different things that could possibly be a secret that we don't know about, but I don't know. It's really up to you guys to find out the secrets, not me. I mean, it wouldn't be fair if I found them out, right? Thank you everyone for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe down below. Do all those cool things I'm supposed to call out at the end of the, like a very good YouTuber is supposed to do, like, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. But that's really your choice. And it's just YouTube. They're like, hey, make sure you do a call to action at the end of your videos so you become popular and stuff. I don't know. Sure. I'll do that. Why not? Love you guys very much. And we'll talk to you very soon. Outro.